The Department of Defense has a proposed budget of $686 billion for 2019. And as you can imagine, the lion's share of that money goes to planes, ships, weaponry, and personnel to fight a conventional war. But the U.S. and its allies are also preparing for a new kind of warfare, fought not on land and sea and air, but across computer networks. NewsHour Weekend Special Correspondent Christopher Livesay has a story from Tallinn, Estonia.
The clock is ticking as NATO jumps into action to protect one of their own.
There are NATO nations that have deterrence force troops on the island of Borrelia, and they're trying to deter aggression from Krenzonia.
Borrelia's power grid has been hacked, its water system contaminated.
The drones, they need to fly their mission around.
And its surveillance drones sent off course, leading Europe to the brink of war.
It may be attacked this way.
No, you haven't missed the latest news from Europe. This is not real war. It's a war game. The largest live-fire cyber defense exercise in the world, involving more than 1,000 experts from 30 nations. It's called Locked Shields. The nerve center of the operation is a hotel ballroom in the picturesque Eastern European city of Tallinn, Estonia. It's the home of the event's organizers, the NATO Cooperative Cyber Defense Center of Excellence.
The most serious threats are coming from nations and nation states affiliated groups.
The center's director, Estonian Meryl Maigra, says in a world more and more dependent on the internet, these war games are more important than ever.
The most dangerous targets are in critical information infrastructure, our banking systems, our traffic control systems, our ports, airports. All of this is run by systems that were set up in the 70s or 80s when cybersecurity measures weren't really the first priority. And thereby they are vulnerable to cyber attacks as more and more systems are linked up with the internet.
So hypothetically speaking, an attacker could target the air traffic control system of a country and cause a plane crash.
Absolutely. Theoretically speaking, you don't really need to start a war by targeting the military. A code can render your fighter pilots incapable even before they take off.
The CCDCOE has been running Locked Shields every year since 2010 with a similar scenario. The fictional country of Krimzonia, which seeks to dominate the region, launches a massive cyber attack against the equally fictional Borrelia. Borrelia calls on its NATO allies for help. Although the scenario isn't real, the attacks are meant to mimic threats that are. Threats like those NATO faces from potentially hostile countries, including Russia.
That is exactly what happened 2 years back in Ukraine when the attacks against the power grid happened.
22 so-called blue teams from NATO and EU nations must defend Borrelia. They'll be ranked on how well they protect its electricity grid, emergency communication system, surveillance drones, and water supply from the hackers. American Commander Michael Widman is one of the coordinators.
These are the actual mock-ups of the water generation plants that we're using during the exercise. You can see the blue team numbers corresponding to the teams that are trying to defend them. This one here has been compromised. The water's turned green, so it's not suitable for human consumption.
Blue is safe. Green means there's too little chlorine in the water supply. Red, too much.
From overall, looking at the models here, three teams have lost control of their water purification plants.
And that's leading to bigger problems.
Citizens from Borrelia have gotten sick. The deterrence force personnel that are on the island are now having to deal with sick personnel, sick Borrelian citizens. They're also dealing with riots. They're also dealing with a proxy group from Krenzonia that are ethnic Krenzonians within Borrelia, and they're taking the advantage of the incidents that are occurring to destabilize the government, essentially.
During the Locked Shields event, defenders usually compete remotely from their home countries. The Estonian team was in secure rooms at CCDCOE headquarters in Tallinn. That's where we found the American team as well. In past years, the U.S. competed on its own and didn't always fare well. In 2017, it came in 12th. This year, the U.S. teamed up with three Baltic countries, including Estonia, which came in second last year.
The more we can learn from one another.
U.S. Army Colonel Brian Vile says it just made sense.
Really, this year was a complete change in tact. We said we're not going to compete individually. Instead, what we're going to do is we're going to cooperate, learn from one another. And that way, if we finish first, or we're with a team that finished first, we make sure that we figure out what they're doing that's so good, and we can take it back to ourselves and hopefully push that back out to all the other teams that we work with and all the other allies.
The game lasts 2 days. In the end, each team defending Borrelia took hits. All the surveillance drones and emergency communication systems were compromised in some way, as were little over half the electricity and water systems.
There's a lot of learning, actually.
Yeah, there is a lot.
The US-Estonia team came in fourth. But Colonel Vile says winning is not the point of locked shields. Learning is.
It's all about cooperation. It's all about information sharing. None of us is as smart as all of us.
Something is very, very wrong.
So the great thing that we're getting out of this is the ability to work with the partners. So if something ever does happen in the real world, we're that much better prepared for it.